is how is Mate working with the channels on the green IT agenda. Simply put, you know, green IT today is covering a full gamut of initiatives, right from the design of a product to the consumption of the product to the disposal of the product. And we're working with the entire ICT ecosystem in the country, where the objective is to educate the manufacturer on the design best practices globally, educate the user on building in the right energy efficiency habits and the right executions to build sustainability in their consumption. And then, of course, once the product has been consumed totally, to take that e-waste and have a safe and compliant disposal of that e-waste. That's actually the program that we are working on. One of the biggest thing at this point of time is building an end customer awareness, and we are having a clear agenda on the full actions, both in terms of awareness, in terms of actual on the ground activation, and in terms of building the compliance systems. So we have done, for example, last month in Ahmedabad, we worked with ECMA, the Ahmedabad Computer Merchant Association. In their flagship event in December, we were the knowledge partner for a workshop on Make It Green, which we executed along with them and the CIO Forum in Ahmedabad to educate the market on the implications of bad habits and uncontrolled, unsustainable executions of IT, and implement certain power saving practices in their organization, which collectively build a saving back for them and for the country as a whole. So this becomes one initiative that would happen. We will actually work in these initiatives with the end user community and with the channels to build a momentum on this. The second example is on the disposal front, so the e-waste. We are right now working with the government on the legislation, and we are working with the industry on creating the implementation guidelines. That means defining how the collections got to be built. In a city like Bangalore, what will be my collection grid? What will be the collection marketing programs? The collection that is done, how is it going to flow into a compliant supply chain? And how will that reporting be done out of it? So that entire process, the rates, the costs, the programs, that's actually being documented at this point of time. And we actually creating channels, you know, the reverse logistic channels for doing this particular execution. Now, the reason I'm saying we're creating these channels is because, strictly speaking, there are going to be multiple channels which will come up for e-waste disposal. And definitely the IT channel will have one role in it. But we should also acknowledge that the current channel for waste movement in the country is not the IT channel. It is actually the kabadiwalas and, the informal sector. So there is a lot of work being done with the informal sector, educating them on the hazards that are there in e-waste handling, what is the right way of handling it, what are the way they can extract economic value out of it, and what are the compliance norms for making that process happen. We even looking at building creativity workshops on e-waste called We Create, where people will actually be trained how to make utility items out of e-waste. We will have a whole lot of programs which are designed to audit e-waste executions and make sure that they are compliant, to give the manufacturers and the government this sort of compliance norms and reports that are required. So there's a whole lot of work that is happening on the ground to make it happen. So it goes across the community. In four cities, in Bangalore and Pune, we have already rolled out poster competitions through schools, and that's been one conscious engagement. We're also trying to see if some of these schools can be made as point collection centers. So a whole lot of activation is happening at this point of time to build this movement. I think the industry was always sensitive to it, and it's been very closely working with the government on the legislations that are there. We have submitted extensive white papers and best practices across the globe on these topics, and I believe that we have legislators and government senior leaders at this point of time who have a vision and who are actually moving in those directions, on those recommendations. And with a little bit of luck, the energy from MATE and the vision of some of these senior leaders will combine to deliver something very powerful for our nation. So that's the way we look at it.